name is Anas in the box, and I am from Department of PBG, Female Relisha and Agriculture. Here I have some maize plants, and I am going to explain them. Maize is a monoecious plant. It has male and female inflorescence at different parts of plant. The female inflorescence is midway to the shoot and known as ear. Here we can see, while the male inflorescence at the top of the shoot and known as tassel. Here we can see. Maize is a 95% cross-pollinated while 5% self-pollinated plant. Now we will explain the male and female inflorescence. Here we see detail about the male inflorescence. The male inflorescence is tassel. Here we can see. The tassel contains the staminate flowers which lack stigma. These are also called male flowers. The stamen contain two flowers. Each spikelet contain two florets, which can produce up to 250 million of pollen grain. This anthesis started 1 to 3 days before this silk appearance, and it will continue 3 to 4 days after. Here we can see the female inflorescence of the males. It is here. It consists of the silk, which act as stigma as well as style. These are actually pollen tubes which receive pollen and transport it to the ovule. Inside the bulb, where we have the female flowers, and each pipette consists of two flowers, while one is fertile and other is not fertile. The pollen tube, which is actually silk, is receptive throughout their length. Now I am going to explain the selfing in maize. Let's suppose it is a plant which is an inbred line I have developed. Well, first of all, we will cover its ear with the butter paper bag. You can see the ear is covered with a butter paper bag. First of all, it should be done before the silk appearance. And we use butter paper bag so we can see the appearance of the silk. While it will cover the ear for some days, and we will check daily for the appearance of silk. One day before we are about to do pollination, we will cover the tassel with a craft paper bag like that. It will stay one day, and the next day we will just do a tap so we can collect as much as pollen grain inside the bag. Then we will carefully remove it and we will replace the butter paper bag with the craft paper bag like that. Now we will give just a tap so it can be pollinated, and it will remain there for a while and until the seed set. While we will also tag this with breeder's name and date of pollination. Now I am going to explain the crossing in maize. Let's suppose I have two inbred lines, line A and line B. I will pollinate the line A with the pollen of line B. First of all, I will cut off the tassel of line A so it can self-pollinate. After that, we will cover this ear with a butter paper bag, and it should be done before the appearance of silk. We will visit daily the field to check the appearance of silk. The day before the pollination, we will go to our plant B and cover its tassel with a craft paper bag so pollen can be collected. We will give it a try so as much as pollen collected in this bag. The next morning, we will take the bag off and take all the pollen and replace the butter paper bag with craft paper bag, and it will remain there until